My name is Talani Thomas.
My name is Kaylee Murray.
How you doing, Devon Art?
I'm DeAndre Varner.
My name is Jacob Matthew.
My name is Adrian Coleman.
And we'll be explaining combo rules 1, 2, and 3.
First common rule is we use commas to separate words and items of three or more. And in journalism, they don't use the third comma because it saves space.
I have commas and asterisks. Basically, and when you utilizing commas and asterisks, you always want to make sure that when using two or more asterisks in a sentence, you have to make sure you use a comma to separate. With that being said, I have an example for you. All right. Mrs. Harris and I are about to release the hottest, freshest mixtape in 2 weeks.
Yes.
All right. Just like I said, when using two adjectives, hottest, freshest, I would make sure you utilize comma in between to separate them. And so, just so I really drive the point, I'm gonna hear rap. Group, go ahead and give me my beat.
Okay.
I live fast.
Are you fast?
No. Right there. And I thought about a name too. They call me C-O-N.
Oh,
oh,
comma.
C-O-N. That's my name. Using two words or more than described, make sure you use the sign with a dotted curved line. But like I said, and to drive my point across, when using two or more words to describe, make sure you use the sign with a dotted curved line. Come.
So rule number three regards to using independent clauses and commas. When you have two independent clauses, you cannot join them by a comma because this will cause a comma spark over an all sentence. The only correct way to combine these two would either be with a semicolon or with a conjunction such as and or but. Because they are two incomplete thoughts. Or you could just separate them and end them both with a period. And that is our last rule.
I'm
Zari Bender.
I'm Alexiana Williams.
I'm Damien.
Sorry, I'm having trouble with the connection. Please try again.
I'm Damien Smooth.
Anita Staten.
Cameron Nichols.
And I'm Zach Collins.
The rules that we will be doing today is 4 or 5.
Okay, so in rule 4A, we use a comma after certain words that introduce a sentence. So for example, no, you can't have my dollar, and no introduces the sentence, so you put a comma after the no.
Okay.
in rule four B, you use commas to when an expression interrupts a natural sentence flow. So this sentence can still be said, I am very nervous. But when it's interrupted by this expression, you have to put commas in order to set off the expression.
Off a name or nickname or term of endearment for a person directly addressed. Now, the sentence is when you ever do the assignment, it's directed on Amber and will she do the assignment. And also, Amber could be anywhere in this sentence, like Amber, will you do the assignment? So this is my rule number five.
So, John lived in Alabama until February 15th, I said to call him for a year. And that would be rule number six.
It has to be rule number seven.
I
Rule number 7 explains for a comma rule when you write a city and a state. So I'm from Troy, Alabama. The comma will go behind the city for the state.
I'll be doing Rule 8. And Rule 8 is pretty simple. You just have to remember where to place a comma if you are a junior. And since I'm a junior, I'll use an example. Back in, I don't know how long ago, but originally, those traditionally, you have to put a comma after your last name. And then if you put a comma after your last name, you would also have to put one after junior. But you don't have to do that, so you could just leave it as Ryan Gray Junior at address. But if you do put a comma, it just has to be another comma after junior. That's it.
Alright, so the rule we all been waiting for, rule number 9.
One example for a rule now would be John Smith and his. This rule would not be correct if it didn't have this comma, because you have to have a comma to close degrees or titles. That's for number
10 about when you use commas and dependent clause. When you start saying with dependent clause, you have to use commas to separate. But if you were to flip it around and say, do not raise your hand if you do not know the answer, you won't have to use commas.
And that's all.
My name is Tyler Woodley.
My name is Akilah Carl. I'm Sydney Austin.
I'm Sean Pope.
I'm Jordan Downs.
I'm Snowy Dotson.
And I'm Jacory Daniel.
And we will be explaining rule number 11.
So rule number 11 is basically saying use commas to set off non-essential words, clauses, and phrases.
The sentence reads, Jill, who is my sister, shut the door. Pretty much, as the rule states, the use of commas are only present to set off non-essential words, clauses, or phrases. And in this case, who is my sister would be non-essential. It can be removed, and the sentence will still make sense. So it would read, Jill, shut the door.
Rule 11B is the use of commas will not be used because the words or phrases are sentences. Like, you say the boy with blue coat, I mean, you can have that, but you really don't need to add commas to it, which makes it. Yeah.